I remember caring about stuff like, how do I post on Instagram to get my followers? And it's like, it's like an Instagram, who gets a post? You know, I just feel like everybody's so stuck in social media, and it's more like famous, but for like doing that. I kind of said they want to become famous because you're a good writer, for singing, for playing the violin, the guitar, the piano, for photography. But becoming famous because you post your laundry routine. Becoming famous because I went to storage at business today, and this is how I'm going to store everything in my house. Like, girl, be so free. Like, everybody wants to get famous off of nothing. And then I consider internet famous, like, real life famous. Because these companies, they want to pay influencers good money. It's good money, but it's cheaper marketing. Period. You get paid, but it's cheaper marketing, so I guess a win-win-win. I guess probably the only reason why they're not using real models and real actors and actresses is because, well, it's easier if we just pay them to post on Instagram than if we just do a whole commercial. I'm kind of just like, why even try to go to after school when this is the shit that's happening? Like, why even try to actually be a model when Instagram models are like making money? I mean, it's giving. All the artistry is taken away because everything's on Instagram and TikTok. But everybody has different things they want in life. Like, some people are comfortable just being an Instagram model or like just being an influencer. Some people really don't want to be an actor or model. They just be like, listen, I got phone and I have brand deals. I'm good. I understand. And I feel like it's only to those that take it for what it is. Some of them take it too far. Like, there's my own Campbell. And then there's Instagram. You know?
Yeah. Other models. I know other models' faces. I can't remember. Like Chantel. Chantel, right? I'm trying to think about them. Damn. I'm really interested in being somebody. So I got a damn phone. My daddy paid this bill. I don't even pay this bill. Like, I'm not about to see it be like, did that pay 1K for that post? Like, no. I want to be in magazines and on movies. Can't wait for my interview. Like, I'm young, but also, like, too old to care about Instagram, that makes sense. You know what I'm saying? Wait. So yeah, this is gonna be part of my Madeline when I be sharing her opinions in my YouTube or podcast. This should be her last opinions post. Talk about the world. Now it's gonna be basic and boring posts. Because I know one day I'm gonna be somebody and I don't have time for any backlash. At all. Cause even though all my parents are offering YouTube videos now, I feel like whenever I become who I'm hoping I become, which is somebody big, I will not be in backlash. I had to go to interviews like Madeline. In 2021, he said, I mean, they're 2021. They'd be like, hey, Madeline, 2022, 2023, you said this, da da da, how do you feel about that now? And it's just like, girl, I'm like 30 years old now. Stop bringing up 2-year-old Madeline. Thank you.
I just don't know why I'm making a video on my phone. I don't think I cleared out the storage. Because I don't know if I told them in my other videos, but I'm in issues with my storage. I didn't know why, but I finally found out why. Whatever. So a part of my Madeline might be top. I know I said I wasn't, but I might not. So here's a few little rapid fire things I wanted to say before I end it, because I made like a 40-minute video and my computer deleted it because I had no storage. So now I gotta do it in this short little list. Because I think I went a little bit too personal in that video. So maybe it's God's willing that it got deleted. Anyways, things I would not be going to death about, but we'll rapid fire shoot in here. And you got part of my face. I'm going to be looking at my face. I'm looking at the camera. White people or non-black people not believing black people aren't profiled or wrongfully terminated. It happens, it's real. Typically, it's racist and prejudice, and let them be. I'm not one of the black people about to educate the black people. I'm not doing it. They think that we commit more crimes. Is it true? they think every time we get shot or killed by a police officer, it was okay. Is that true? You know, to have the conversation about race is redundant. It is redundant. I think a lot of people, I mean, there's limits. I'm not talking about race. I don't mean like in a serious setting. I'm talking about on the internet. Like, people have these conversations about race. Basically, black people going back and forth with white people. That's what I mean. Like, we can't always go back and forth with people who are going to use confirmation bias. Because a lot of them do. Some of them are not having conversations, or they do a little, what's it called, like a duet or like a remix or whatever it's called, where you have somebody's video and then other part of yours. Like, it's a stop. Like, people are going to be racist and prejudiced. Like, we cannot fix people, white people who are like that. We cannot. They're going to believe that we're the worst people in the world. We're probably going to believe the rest of the world. I mean, they people did commit mass genocide, you know, slavery. But hey, they think that we're the horrible people because of what God, only God knows why people think like that. Other than racism, I don't freaking know. I am white. I don't know why they hate us so much. Well, I do know why. But I don't know their mindset. I'm going to get it. Anyways, everybody take a YouTube seriously. Listen. I know I'm not even a YouTuber. Don't call me that. Don't call me influencer either. Somebody just said, oh, baby, you don't eat. No, baby. Man. No. Probably just like, you're an influencer. Do YouTube and like podcast. I'm like, oh, no. And the reason why I say that is because everybody taking YouTube seriously and asking people ridiculous questions, which is crazy. Like, y'all just going on here, camera, saying ridiculous stuff, acting, not rashy, but acting like a big body, trying to get rashy out of people. And I'm kind of like, let's see people enjoy their day. Like, girl, stop. Going viral just for doing the most to go viral. I've seen like some of my dudes like had a cup. It was like all the way up in the air, like stacking the cup up in the air. It was just like the mindset, like you have to like literally sit at home and think how to go viral. It's not even just a regular day about like, I guess like it's about money, but it's kind of just like, when like, not get the point. It's like it's just like it's crazy, and then it's very it's not concentrated, but it's too much about the same stuff. Like what I said in the first part of the video about the laundry, it's that all over again. It's like 20 different moms. Last time I was on Twitter, I'm gonna have to talk anymore. That's why I was on there just, here's like, I got kids lunch. Oh well, since you're out there, I got my kids lunch. I'm on this side. It's just like I can't imagine like having like a regular day, your personal life, and then posting it, they have random comments, and then people actually, then you mean, you know, people who make these posts take in their comments and like do something for them. Like, do these people ever think, like, this is crazy that thousands of random strangers are telling me what to do about my household, telling me what to do with my daily life? Like, y'all ever think that the internet is getting a little bit too far? Like, y'all, like, this shit is normal? Because I can tell right now there's not. And I bet the many, I really hope that Instagram, TikTok, and Twitter, they all just shut down. Facebook, too. And people could really realize, like, oh, so here's a day where I don't record every single thing I do. Here's a day where the people don't know what my child is like. Because you post your child's face every day. And people are stealing children. Like clockwork. Like clockwork every day. They're stealing kids like it's nothing. I cannot. They take it too seriously. And it's like, why are you still going to try to go viral on YouTube, Twitter, TikTok, whatever, over the age of 29? I'm sorry, but that's all that's fucked to still be worried about internet, about the internet and trying to make money. And I want to be humble. Like, one part of me, I get it. Like, I get it for those. Let me say this. I mean that for people who are posting on YouTube and TikTok that have that obviously can bring them higher up. Now, those who post skits, I have seen those people turn to like actors and actresses, possibly get commercial, but they get somewhere off of that. I understand that, but like I said, those records of the pranks and the comedians, they get pretty far off of Instagram and off of TikTok as well. Like, I see you using it to promote your career, but I mean, using it as your career is like, at some point you get too old. You just do, but that's, hey, make your money, honey. Toxic masculinity. Listen, I hate me. Okay, now I'm getting personal. I don't like no men. I'm a man. That's, I can't deal with that. I'm a man because I'm big as fuck. I'm violent. I got a deep voice. I just like a regular dude. Like, he's just a dude. He can make jokes. I can put nail polish on his hands and he won't be like, oh my, boy, don't do that. He kind of be like, man, why do that? The man really type of vibe. You know what I'm saying? Or like, oh, hey, babe, I'm about to spill on you. This is for a joke. He be like, okay, sure. You know, you're just gonna do that. But some of y'all are so stuck that if a man is just making a joke, even like with, like, not like making fun of women, but you know, just doing it just for the sake of having fun, oh, he gay all of a sudden. Oh, his voice is kind of weird. He's like, crazy, he must be gay. That's the way he walks. He must be gay because the way he walks. Y'all, you know how many gay men look just like every other straight man? The same way how y'all accuse straight men of being gay just for doing some regular shit. It goes both ways. It goes both ways. I mean, it's just a video of Javante Davis just dancing, and y'all be like, oh, he got some sugar in his tank. I'm like, oh, here we go. And there was the New York Jets. I don't know. I don't have like football shorts and like YouTube videos, but I don't know the player names. That's how many players. Like, how do y'all remember their names? It's like hundreds of them. Gosh. Whatever. And they asked me, like, where like the vacation at? He said Turks or Barbados. He said Turks or Barbados. I haven't decided yet. Oh, I was in a man voice. But to me, it was fun. I would date a man like that. He's such a sweetheart. You know, another big man. He has like a very like manly voice, but like soft, sweet voice. You know, like, you know how to do it, but it's so soft, so sweet. I'm like, oh my god, that's I would date a man like that. I don't like, you know, roughnecks. That's actually called those over magically. Well, I think you know, I mean, how could be over magically, but you can be over magically. Someone got to be pushing it. But his husband really sucks. And so women actually double down on it. I think any of Chopper gave Lil Wayne some flowers. And people are like, oh my god, I can't believe another man giving them man flowers. It's just like, it's not even romantic, dude. They get flowers when you don't want to play. They get flowers at pageant. It's literally just like, it's a freaking gift. Like, everything just gotta be gay. Nothing could just be nothing. It literally just, when here your flowers. Like, he took the term literal. And I mean, I was a little way. I'd be thankful. I would have been like, a new man give me flowers and not everything's gay. Like, please, pipe down. Please, along the way, the man ain't wearing no thongs. They were like, you're probably not gay. You don't like up the ass. Because at the end of the day, that's the only thing to determine somebody gay. Does he like it up his ass, okay? Not the way he talks, not the way he does, or not the way he walks. Does he like it up his ass? Only way. Next. White shame. It's stupid. It's dumb. I literally just seen a YouTube video with another those dumb YouTube videos about like, oh, can I get your number? No. Oh, hit me off my Lamborghini. Here the girl come. And the college were like, ooh, they need to go tell this girl to go get a gym membership. Cause this girl was shaped like me. Hold on. And I know that how if this video gets viral, that has like ignorant fools that want everyone to be a size 100, not size, but weigh 120 pounds. And baby, this is a 7'6" body. 120 pounds, hell to no. That's too damn low. Can never be that low. But she was straight, pretty much like me. You know? Come on. I hope I don't break this chair. It's more like plastic. But pretty much straight like me. Her stomach, I don't know how to explain it, but her stomach, she was like medium thick. You know, like she had like a little stomach, but it would have no rolls. It didn't hang over her belly, it didn't hang over her crotch. And they were like, oh, she needs to go to a gym membership. I'm looking at her body, like, she has the most basic body. Like, women lose weight and have some type of body. You know what I'm saying? People have to go to a gym membership. It goes back to my other video, talking about, like, why does the world want everybody to be, not everybody, that's only certain people. Which is why I feel like race isn't too, like, I already said that later. Nothing wrong. Like, white people do be having, like, thick bodies, but of course, the comments who wanted her to be itty bitty and tiny, the white people. And I'm just saying that the black community is kind of more so known for us to always have like curves, basically. So, and she was black, so I mean, I guess in my eyes, she had a very normal body. But to those other cultures where having curves isn't, I'm not saying it's impossible to not have curves being white, but maybe not as popular or known. They're like, oh my god, she's so freaking fat. And I bet white boys think I'm fat too, but no, this is a cornbread fed. Nice body, man. What? More people should go to therapy, and it also goes with people dating but not for the healing. And this is when I was in high school, actually. I seen this all the time with boys. It was like a whole, what's it called? A trend. The boys were like, hanging around. I didn't break. And it's just like, even high school, I was kind of like, boy, you don't send that girl back to the guy she came from. I'm like, why are y'all so focused on moving on and dating? But like, not being okay with yourself. Like, there's limits between, you know, like, oh, well, I don't have trust, but I think some women, some men be like fully broke. Like, I don't want to call somebody broken, but they be still so hurt and stuck in the past that it shows up in a relationship. Like, they try to treat you like the person that hurt them. It kind of just like, that's not a you problem, that's a them problem. They should have never gotten a relationship. And y'all need to start holding these people accountable. Like, bro, like, you're not ready for a relationship. Like, why did you do this? Like, why did you come here? That's how I feel. And y'all shouldn't be letting them use an excuse anymore. Like, y'all should talk. Y'all need to stop. Leave people where they at. Be like, oh, you know what, we're dating someone? Bye. Not know, like, oh, well, I understand what she did to you. I understand. Like, I'll be like, you know what? I was sending you my therapist. I was sending, yes. She's not booked off. She's not booked off. He is booked off. I don't know what to say. I can, like, oh, was never going to appoint him. But I'll send you his, link anyway, so schedule appointment. Or, you know, go look on Psychology Today and you can go find with somebody, okay, honey? Because I'm not your therapist. No. I'm not. God is not using me to be your vessel to fix you. God created therapists for a reason, and that's where you're going. Yeah, not me. No. I don't believe in it. And if you do, you'd be like, well, you know, my husband, he took me all in. Like, that's what I heard about. I don't believe that you should do that. I feel like you should be able to go get help. If they're putting it all around your husband. I mean, people call it baggage, but limit it. Like, you know, like, I feel like you were hurt and broken. And you don't know, you're still hurt and broken. You wrong. Period. Like, you did that wrong. Go get help. Even if you gotta be childhood trauma, go fix your trauma. Go get it, like, just go. I don't understand, y'all. I just don't get it. Alright, what's next? I just said that. Okay. Now, every man's a whore. Y'all be acting like, I don't understand this. And I also believe that whatever makes a man a whore makes a woman a whore. Whatever makes a woman a whore makes a man a whore. I don't know that the standard. This rapper, he was talking about how, don't know about what rappers. And that man said, he was on his 40s, and he was saying he hit the whole face in 30. I'm like, oh my god, y'all men be old as hell, never trying to just be normal. So I think like, fuck, I hate the whole face, he's an old ass age. Like, y'all just care, y'all just care, y'all be scared as, y'all be scared of pregnancy. But at the point, y'all should be scared though. Nasty little freaks. Basically saying that the women, we are the key, and that, no, we're the locks, and men are like the keys, you know, like, basically trying to say that not every key should be able to like unlock a woman or whatever. He's like, you know, I'm a key. I want the whole lot of hoes. Like, he was just saying he's fucked a lot of people. Like a lot. And then he was talking about his girlfriend over there, kind of thing. And she was like, you know, I look good in the present. He's like, yeah, you know, I'm not really good fucking. Basically, you know, I'm kind of like, I don't agree, okay? That's me personally. That's my opinion. I don't agree that a man can't be a hoe, but a woman can't for the same stuff. That's foolish to me. It's foolish. You know, it's crazy. And then, I don't know, like, I do accept every guy I date or ask who they are, but God knows my heart. I do like men who don't. I like men who care about their bodies. I feel like men should. Cause I don't believe that it's a numbers game. I don't know who taught her that. I don't know who your friends are. I don't know who that is. But men and boys should have also learned that your body's also a temple. You can't be fucking anybody. You can't be fucking any girl. You gotta like this girl. Where this girl been at? What should you do? Did you fuck anybody? Did she have any STDs? Like, do you know her? Is the smell that you clean? Do you know her? You can't fuck anybody. Like, boys should still learn that they cannot be fucking anybody because of how great they are. Take care of their body. You know, they should take care of your brain and your mind and your mental, and your spiritual. They should learn that too, not only girls, but also boys, and they don't. I don't know, I cannot. I wish my husband would tell my son to go out and be a hoe because he a boy. I wish I knew. You be the first to be out of it. You better not. You better not teach my son toxic masculinity either. That's not. I do not believe in it. But anyways, like I was saying, not every man is a whore. Yes, I know it's crazy to believe that not every man just wants to go sleep around a woman. Because some men actually don't want STDs or want to be girls pregnant and just be there with daddy. No, not every man wants to be mechanic. I mean, I totally believe that's real. Like, it's so wild that some men are just not hoes. It's crazy. Because some of y'all be so damn surprised that men don't want to fuck anybody and everybody. And some people just freaking don't. Like, some just don't. And those are the ones I love the most. I'm like, wow, you don't just care to fuck anybody because she lets you fuck? You're like, yeah, I turned it down because what the fuck? I'm like, I feel that. Because, yeah, like, what the fuck? And then you're like, that's really not what I'm supposed to say that. Anyways. Not everybody wants to be extraordinary, have like extraordinary lives. Like, I don't know, I heard this whole thing about being like known and popular. But there are some things you can't be known for. And I mean, I don't really care to be famous. But unfortunately, in the careers I go into, the more known you are, the more money you make. I mean, that's really how acting and modeling works. Well, not so much modeling. I mean, commercial modeling, you still make a good deal of money. Okay. Don't need to be famous for that. I mean, hey, if I'm getting it paid, we get. And for being a writer, I don't think people are that known for being a good writer. I could write it, but I don't even know as a writer either. So yeah, that's not a big deal. But I feel like everybody in my mind would be like, oh, what? Not everybody in my mind, but like, these little like millionaires that got millions from God knows where. But they'd be like, oh, you still like your 9 to 5? You have your own business yet? You just get on the TikTok wave. It's like, girl, stop talking down people 9 to 5. Like, people like, some people like construction. People like being real estate agents. Some people like being doctors. Some people like being lawyers. Some people like being teachers. Not everybody takes their job, ma'am. Some people like working at the bank. Some people like being an office administrator. Like, people are fine with a job. They're fine with their job. Okay, ma'am? Like, not everybody is trying to be the entrepreneur and they're trying to be a podcaster. Make the money from that, and everybody wants to be a fashion designer. People are okay with these 9 to 5 jobs. Damn, let people be, my God. Let people be. No, and it's crazy. But I mean, that's all I had on my list. It was very short. And I think I did that on purpose because as I'm writing it down, I'm gonna think of anything else that we say. So that's it. I think I did miss shit. I don't understand how race and dating goes together. But I think that's a very deep conversation. Comfort about who is light-skinned and with curly hair. I honestly believe that I can't really say nothing because I'm not like. What I'm trying to say is I've seen a Facebook post and a light-skinned girl looked like me was married or dating, and she was dating very well. Not dating very well, but this man took a very good care of her. It was a black man, and they were just like, you know, like how, there was one comment talking about, well, you of course, which I was gonna say in her comments or her Facebook post that. You don't need to date outside of your race to get this type of love. And one comment was like, well, you know what? You're light-skinned and you're the type of guy that all black guys want. You know, da-da-da. And dark-skinned, I don't know if you're dark-skinned, she's brown-skinned woman, has said that. So that's why I'm saying I can't really say much about that. All I can say is I do believe a lot of black men love brown and dark-skinned women. Okay? So I would say that if that's what you really want, you know, if you can't have it, if you can't find it, it doesn't have to be a turn to black men that you are dating. I've always told my mom, but mom lied to me, so. I think it's just certain, it's just so black men that some women are dating that it just, like, look, I mean, I'm like, I haven't met all great black guys. Some black guys don't like black women. Like, let's be so for real. They don't. And at this point in age, I don't have time to argue with nobody about who they do or don't like. I don't like that conversation on the internet is pointless as well. That's their own ignorance. Whenever Latina or white lady they have to deal with that, because I feel like that's got to be like so heavy, like to deal with somebody who don't like their own. None of my damn business. Because I'm a black man and I love him, a black woman. Okay, we're gonna be okay. I also don't understand the whole prefaces debate. I mean, I do have a thought behind it, but I don't get a whole lot of backlash if I say it all out. I'm not. But I am gonna say having preference is fucking normal. You're not gonna be everybody's type. I'm not everybody's type. let people date who like the whole idea, like the main argument I seen about it was like everybody should like everybody, like period. That was literally the debate. I see a lot of men and women saying everybody should like everybody, should not like somebody not because of this, they should not like somebody only because of this. And it's like, that's how freaking dating and liking works. Like, all my celebrity crushes look alike because that's how people that I like. Like, it's not really like a diss to the opposite. Like, that's where I feel like it's wrong. And, like, you're dissing the opposite of what you're like, that's where you're wrong. But you just typically have a preference. It's kind of just like, how do you freaking not have a preference? You out here dating anybody that look like anything? Like, you don't have at least something physical that you like specifically. Like, be for real. I just don't get the debate. And then on top of that, none of your fucking business either. I think that was one of the main things I was trying to say in here too. There's too many like conversations about how to go about your own personal life. And that was one of them. Like what do I do with you? What the fuck did I do with you? If he don't like how you, the type of girl that love you, what I gotta do with you? I would like an answer now. What did I have to do with you? Not a damn thing. Oh, also, I want to talk about religion. Listen, I have a religion. I love God. I believe in God. I don't believe in these internet pastors. Not street pastors. Not pastors that post a sermon online. I mean, like, pastors who go out to go talk. Not even talk to people about how great God is. They kind of like judge people. Like, I just don't believe in like judging people into loving God. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's one thing to say, oh, hey, can I pray for you real quick? Or like, hey, can I tell you how amazing God is? That's one thing. But to go up to a Muslim man and have to tell him about his own culture. Because y'all understand, some religions are actually a culture, not just a religion. You know? You gotta tell them off about that, and try to like tell people about them. It's, some of this is kind of rude, low key. Not if it steers away from you trying to go viral, then you loving God. You know, everybody has their own. Some things I feel like are like more so associated in the Bible, but I'm not going into detail about that. Like a man, he went in Target to make a whole video just about how gay everything was. Whereas Target has done this for every single Pride Month, so I'm kind of like, I don't understand why people are going crazy, because I mean, it has been every Pride Month they've done this, right? At least I remember. So I just don't like that. And going up to Muslim people, going up to people who may believe in astrology and stuff, and I do crazy, like, how is something really against God? Because like, I don't know, there's one that's like writing down stuff and like talking out loud about it. But then there's also God that says, the word of the mouth, something like that, the word of the mouth. It's kind of just like, okay, like, is it against God or was it just not in the Bible? Because I feel like some things that come from the spiritual world is literally in the Bible, but they just say, they slap spiritual in front of it and say the universe instead. You know what I mean? I mean, like, God created the universe. I mean, I'm sorry, that is too much about religion and God. That is like, there's a Bible, and regardless of that fact, let's be real, people. We gotta be real. People are still gonna assume the Bible differently. They're still gonna read it differently. They're still gonna get not assume. What's the word? Okay, I guess what I'm trying to say, they're gonna get different things from the Bible. Is what I'm trying to say. You know, they're gonna get different things. So yeah, I want to start reading my more, but I'm tired of listening to these internet people about it, telling you what is and isn't God. Because, I mean, was it or was it not in the Bible? At that point, that's going to be my question. What scripture said that this is not of God? What scripture said this was of not God? You know what I'm saying? Like, that said it. I mean, tell me where they said this is about God. I mean, I feel like I would know the answer to that already, but you know what I'm saying? Like, and like I said, this, some of them, I can't, y'all like see the videos I'm trying to say. Like, some of them definitely just look like they're just doing it just to go famous. And just like, I do believe that you should spread the word of God, but there are just certain ways to go about it. And some people just don't go about it in a very like godly way. To go about it very judgmental kind of rude way. I just don't think that's right. You know, everybody has their own religion. I mean, I'm not gonna like tell somebody their religion is wrong because I'm Christian and Catholic. I'm not doing that. No, it's rude. It's very disrespectful. It is. I'll also judge people for things they don't know how to do. There could be a million people that know this skill and another million that don't know. Like, it's not a big deal. I feel like I would judge people like, you know how to jump rope? Oh my gosh. You know how to ride a bike? Oh my gosh. You know how to cook? Oh my gosh. Even though cooking is a thing that everybody should know how to do, but y'all, some people just don't know how to do that. I mean, at least I know how to do it well. Y'all be surprised. And then this whole, like, men, what was I about to say? Oh, men should know how to cook too, because that's like a normal thing. But okay, I'm gonna say this real quick. I think every woman and man should have their own idea of what marriage is. Like, I mean, not women, couples. Because I seen on, I mean, I was when I did have Instagram and stuff, that this man was making fun of his wife for not cooking for him. Because he stayed, I guess because she was home all day. I don't freaking know. But, and she was at work, I guess, for some of the day. I don't know. It was still bright outside. I don't freaking know. And basically, I guess he said, I told her like 30 minutes ago I was hungry. Boy, for 30 minutes, you had time to go drive to go get you some fast food. You had time to cook. You had time to go to the grocery store, come back home and cook it. You know, because I think he told her more than once that he was hungry. And I'm like, first of all, as a woman, how do you get yourself in a situation where a man is depending on you to fucking eat? A grown man depending on you to eat. Listen, I'm not one of those wives or women that believe in these duties that you have to comply to, like, to heart. I feel like, in comply, like, what the fuck are duties? First of all. I feel like wifely duties to me, I don't think they're, like, sex. I'm so sorry. Like, babe, I'm gonna do my laundry. You know how to do your own laundry, nigga. Like, please. Oh, if I had to cook for you, man, you know how to cook. Put the clean up. I mean, but the house dirty to all these people that like to go clean. Like, what does that have to do with me being his wife? Not a damn thing in the house had to do with being somebody's wife. Let's be for real. Now, being a wife is probably, like, emotional stuff. You know, like, just being a person, not being a maid or a chef, had nothing to do with being a wife. For me, some women, that is their wife, who be like, I'm a fixing my man. Me, personally, I date guys that like to cook. See, I haven't worked out. I date guys that like to cook. Now, just know how, but like to. You know, I gotta be smart with it. I'm there. God knows what I want. I don't got time to explain it to you. Cause y'all know, cause I do what the fuck I wanna do. Y'all know how many men actually do cook for their wives? I know y'all be like over here, it's like, men cook and not the wire, cause no longer 1953. Yeah, some men actually cook for their families, and I mean, it's so crazy. It's like the craziest thing to ever think about, that some men cook. Do you know that some men also clean? Some men also clean. It's crazy to believe that a working man cooks and cleans. What? And he doesn't depend on his wife to feed him, because he's a grown man. I can't believe it. This is crazy to me. This is crazy. You know, someone that has to take care of their kids? Mm-hmm. Like, I've been seeing just men just with their kids by themselves. It's crazy. It's so surprising. Or, like, in the neighborhoods, like, the mom's not home. They just hanging out with their sons and their daughters. It's just like, wow, you never see this. Like, this is why y'all need to get the internet. Like, y'all be out thinking that women put it just cater to you. No, you know, take care of your man and cater to him and do different things. I'm sorry. I mean, like, what the fuck? Like, what do you mean cater to? Like, be like a second mom to him? I mean, I'll make him a butt bag after he cooks us dinner. I'll make him a butt bag. You know what I'm saying? I'll fold his laundry if I'm home. If I'm not working, am I home all day? If his laundry just so happened to be in the laundry room, then share him his laundry. You know men also do laundry? I know, it's so crazy. Like, men actually know how to do adult things, even though they're married. They actually do adult things while married. This is a wild concept. have no idea what this concept of a man just being a man. I don't know. That's why I said I feel like marriage is different for everybody. I feel like for me, marriage, I don't feel like I'm going to treat my husband like a roommate. But just because we're married does not mean he needs to lose his independence. And that also shouldn't mean that I need to lose my independence either. I'm saying, no, I'm not going to say that. But yeah, I mean, I just feel like people need to marry who they like. And not who they like, but they should have like some idea like what husband and wife mean to people. I feel it's different for everybody. Marriage is different for everybody. I mean, I don't understand the point of dating and not getting married, but that just means some people just don't like marriage. And life is about perspective. I'm gonna make like a whole podcast video about that. That is literally not about anybody's. Well, some people are wrong, but a lot of things about perspective. That's why you shouldn't get to arguments over the internet, because some people just think differently. People have gone through different things. People have seen different things. Some people just don't fucking read either. I've seen that. Like, I remember Sheree, they had posted her saying that, oh, she hasn't got her face done, work done, because she looked different. She looked different. So different in one of the Real Housewives TV episodes. And the comments was like, oh, she did get work done. And just like, baby. The caption said recently. It said recently. Sheree has been pretty open about getting her work done, but baby, the cops just had recently. It would literally kind of be impossible for Sheree to say she never got work done, because she really has gotten work done on the show, honey. Like, but some people don't read. They just don't. It is okay. Get a post comment. We see it all the time. I was like, okay, girl. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's whatever. Like, people just have different perspectives in life, you know? Like, you can't argue all the time. You can't really tell somebody to get married. You can't really tell somebody how to be a wife. First of all, I also think some of y'all should stop posting our damn business on social media. Speaking of Keke Palmer, her boyfriend, I'm not going to detail about that. Some of y'all are mad crazy for personalizing it, internalizing it, having, like, opinions about it, like, having, like, long comments about it. I'm just like, ah. My own comment about it is that should have been handled at home behind closed doors. That's my only comment, period. That should, if you shouldn't have made the comment public, like, y'all celebrities nowadays, like, why can't y'all just start for friends only? Y'all shit, like, why everything gonna be, well, it's already a public account. I look what if I was famous popular immediately? Friends only, private, immediately. Like what? Anyway, that's just me though. It should have never been public, and I feel like they could have turned it into like a joke, or hell, me, I would have freaking ignored it and be like, I mean, why did he make a joke? If a guy, okay, I ain't gonna go into. I feel like I would just make a joke about it. I'd be like, you know, what do you say? You say, you mom though, and I would just be like, I don't know what I say, but like. I have a question about you see me walk out the house. And I might be like, and what about it? And what about it? I'm a mama, and what about it? Or I'll be like, wish I had her ass out. And I'll be like, and this ass got the baby here. And this body got this baby here. This body got your baby here. That's what I would have done. Since you wanna play, let's play in public. Let's go. You know, but that's just my personality. I probably would have taken it seriously. And I probably would have played a joke on it. So everybody in Atlanta that's seen on social media can just pipe the fuck down. And I take everything to heart. And everything's got to be about you. You know, that's what I'm saying. Like, people just be over here. Lord of Jesus. Like, people, like, celebrities cannot just live them lives. They just can't. They just can't. Damn, maybe I shouldn't try to work on my dreams. Because for the minute I get famous, I'm going to hiding. Y'all know how Beyonce be hiding? How y'all think Kerry Washington hide? Can't tell me, Kerry Washington's pretty famous. Who her husband? What her kids look like? What her mom and daddy look like? Like, we don't know nothing about this woman. She's definitely like, she's like, oh no, y'all will not mind your business. That's how I'll be. Don't marry to none of your business. How about my kids look like, what's your kid's name? I don't freaking know. What's your mom look like, I have a mama, I didn't know that. Y'all know me for whatever the hell I do. And that's all y'all need to know. Okay, have a good day. Like, no, I'm not doing it. Y'all are weird. The internet is very weird. Some of y'all are creepy. Some of y'all are going to death. about one of the people's personal lives. I'm just like, y'all weird. That's it. Like, the lady sings who her man is. For kids, I don't care. When her next album coming out? Like, you know, what a person I got to do with me? And like, that's why I feel like I kind of get weird with celebrities too. Like, they be going out shopping. It's like, ma'am, you're famous. Like, you don't have to do this type of stuff. Like, we're just regular people. I mean, you're regular people too, but I mean, like, and it's like something you post to like close friends, and like, here we hang out for lunch today. It's like, yeah, man. It's weird. Like, we're showing their house off. It's like, ma'am, we could be searching where people are crazy. They would find that house, like on clockwork. I think some of your homes are public knowledge. Journal websites, whatever, make articles about your houses. I mean, like, maybe that's just me, but if I was a celebrity, I'd be really private. Or at least try my best to be private. I feel like I would want to share stuff, but at the same time, just like, who the fuck are y'all? Are y'all fans? That's sweet. But who are y'all? Like, back up. If anyone with YouTubers, they about to say like house tour. Man, not in the driveway. And I just don't. I know some of you flaunting that. Y'all know that one YouTube people. They be like, we're not flaunting. We didn't come from nothing. Then I'm not gonna lie, the first two videos, I'm just saying like, hey, you know, like me and my wife, we ain't cover much, you know, I got it. I'm like, oh, okay, you gonna cover much, you're talking like, I live with your life, you know? And then they just kept doing like these cleaning videos more than once, she got doing the cleaning videos. I'm like, okay, I mean, she's very entertaining, she's mad pretty. I mean, I ain't gay, but I like looking at pretty women. But a lot of straight girls like that. Then she kept doing these videos about stalking her friends. I mean, she got a good body, so that her husband, that just, they had a whole lot of unhealthy stuff. I mean, I know they have kids, but I mean, it was like mad unhealthy. I'm judging. But not the point. And I'm just like, I mean, we get it, you have big as hell. Like, and if you have the kind of mad lie, no, you're going to change that, the toilet tissue. Man, we're happy for you. We got that TikTok. The reason why you make y'all this money. Not only, and I've had another reason, but we got you able to make. I think it was all influencing. But whatever, we got you able to make this money. But you can't say that you're not flaunting your house while flaunting your house. It's not computing. It doesn't compute. Yeah, I don't understand. Like, why do you want to show people? That was my question. Like, why? Who are these people? You know, do what you want to do in life. If life is everything's in perspective, try not to get mad too much or too easily. Pray. Does he believe in me and pray? Like I said, I love my God, but I cannot just be one of those people that disrespect other people's religion. Like, not in a way of like, oh, so you don't spread God's love. No, I don't mean that. I'm just saying like, there's ways to go about it and people to do it. Yeah. That's it, I think. And I guess it's mainly for me, it's just like not to get upset so easily. Remembering that a lot of things are redundant, and it's probably why I don't like social media, because people just repost the same stuff. They say that it could be a different person, but they say the same thing. Some of these stuff has been going on for years. You know, same stuff, same conversation the internet has gone on for years, same stuff about race has gone on for years. Conspiracy theories that are just, some of them make you nervous, some of them are just so freaking ridiculous. And it's just a whole lot of, basically, that I don't feel like even commenting on, because I don't want to be someone of the people that would be a part of the population that's making stuff redundant. But like I said, this is a video not even for people to see. This is like my personal diary. I mean, like, that's why I don't really, like, promote it often. I feel like my YouTube should be, like, if people find me, people find me. You know, I'm never one of those. If I'm like, oh, I'm going to post it on my YouTube every day. I mean, on my Instagram every day. I'm going to post it on TikTok every day. I'm going to post it on my Facebook. Everybody can finally see it. Sure. Like, what are you talking? I don't know. You know, like, if you find this, great. If you don't, that's alrighty. But how you know I'm gonna say that you didn't find the video? You know? So it's just like, it's whatever, it's fine. Okay, now. So, yeah. This might be the last post. And y'all, let me say this one. Again, about not getting upset and mad. Cause this is like me. Some people take a shit too seriously. A woman went a whole rant about why Disney princess dresses should not be the color they are. People like, imagine being mad about Disney princess colors. Imagine being mad about this. Going to have a rant about this. You're like, so crazy. Who rants about this? Why are you so mad about this? A rant does not mean permanently angry, honey bun. I could go on rants all about a whole bunch of shit. And 2 minutes later, you've been mad. You're so mad. I was like, I was never mad. I was just going on a quick little rant about why they have so many Chick-fil-A's. Like, it's not that serious. It's never that serious. But I feel like anytime somebody posts on the internet, whereas a rant or a long poll, they're like, you're so pressed. Like, even like in person, like, it's like, damn, you can't say shit when people think you're insane. Like, I feel like we talk about how I felt that team was the color blue. You'll be like, oh my god, you're so sick of the team the color blue. Like, you'll never be upset about this kind of blue they are. It's just like, honey, but if you tell me to be about it, and I probably would have known me with that scene. Like, you need to relax. Cause that's giving me. And I would definitely have a whole lot of videos about the Disney princesses are all connected theory. I sure would. But you know, people just think that everything is angry and upset. Like, just you know, rants does not always mean people are really upset as they seem to be in the videos. Like, you know what I'm saying? They're just not. Okay, so now I'm done. I think there's everything. The video is not going to be this long, but that's it. My next video, they're probably going to be, I keep saying it's going to be like old videos, but I do have some recent ones. I had to edit them and then post them. And then other videos might be from like a year ago. Yeah. And then they're probably going to be just doing my hair, you know, random basic stuff, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I'm probably going to start doing movie reviews, trying to TV reviews. And like songs to listen to and stuff like that. I'm gonna do that. I'm doing stuff like that now. But yeah, that is it. I'm done with these opinion posts because I'm tired of everybody's name. I'm not trying to say their opinion and I'm not trying to be a hypocrite. You know, I'm trying my best to be more like a godly woman. I mean, I am failing a lot, but it's a journey. It's a journey with God. So I'm taking my time. I'm working on it. I'm trying to be as angry either. Can I get mad? So, it's a process. It gives me starting off to not be a hypocrite. So, until I start judging others for what I do, then I'll get back to posting my opinion and stuff. Bye.